Michael Jackson not only conquered pop music, becoming the biggest selling artist in the world, but also generated a considerable fortune in a number of commercial ventures emerging during his heyday. Whether from multi-million dollar endorsement deals with Pepsi at the height of the Cola Wars, achieving the highest selling home video releases at the advent of the home VCR system, or designing sneakers for LA Gear as part of the 1980s fitness craze. So it's no surprise that Michael Jackson would also cross over into the booming video game trade as part of one of the industry's earliest direct celebrity endorsements. Michael Jackson's collaboration with SEGA, Moonwalker, was the name of several video games based on the 1988 Michael Jackson feature film of the same name. Released in the summer of 1990, Moonwalker was introduced into arcades, and a version was also released for Sega consoles, as well as for home computers that same year. But how did this groundbreaking collaboration come about, and what was the reaction to the King of Pop's crossover into the video game market? Here's the detail. After a boom in popularity for arcade gaming in the 1970s, the early 1980s saw the introduction of at-home video gaming, and the market was quickly flooded with a number of video game consoles and accompanying games by various non-reputable manufacturers, many of which were of a poor quality due to their desire to quickly cash in on the new technology-led craze. Therefore, the US saw a video game crash in 1983 that lasted until the introduction of Nintendo's Famicom, short for Family Computer. The Famicom quickly became a commercial success in Japan, with 2.5 million consoles sold by the start of 1985. Working with Nintendo of America division, Nintendo rebranded the Famicom as the Nintendo Entertainment System, or NES, giving it the appearance of a video cassette recorder rather than a toy-like device. With over 35 million NES systems sold, Nintendo had revitalized the industry, as by 1989, the US market was worth over $5 billion, Nintendo accounting for about 80% of the home video gaming market. Nintendo's competitor Sega launched its own console to compete, releasing Sega Mark III, also known as the Master System, in 1985. Whereas Nintendo had more success in Japan and the United States, Sega's Master System sold well in Europe, Australia, and Brazil. Numerous video game franchises got their start during this period. Super Mario Bros. Debuted in 1985 and established Mario as Nintendo's mascot, as well as the first Super Mario franchise. Sega also introduced their first mascot characters, the Oopa Oopa ship from Fantasy Zone in 1986, later to be replaced by Alex Kidd or Alex Kidd in the Miracle World the same year, though neither gained the popular recognition that Mario had obtained from Nintendo. Aside from creating their own host of characters to spawn franchises off of, Nintendo's most popular game of all time was a collaboration of boxing heavyweight champion Mike Tyson, called Mike Tyson's Punch-Out. With more than 3 million cartridges sold since its introduction in 1986, Sega decided to compete by recruiting other well-known sports figures for their very own games, including basketball coach Pat Riley in Pat Riley Basketball, quarterback Joe Montana in Joe Montana Football, and boxer Buster Douglas in Buster Douglas Knockout Boxing, to name just a few. Slapping famous names on game cartridges seemed an obvious marketing strategy. But Sega was also interested in exploring uncharted waters by releasing the first home video game to feature a non-sports celebrity, and introducing a new category to the gaming market called the musical video game. After the young star's rise to fame, Michael Jackson found himself with a significant amount of wealth that allowed him to enjoy many of his childlike interests, one being his passion for pinball and arcade video gaming, in which he would indulge in at his family's games room in Los Angeles. After Jackson's purchase of Neverland in 1988, he ensured the property had its own dedicated arcade, which was fully stocked with the latest hardware, regardless of the cost. The arcade at Neverland Ranch featured a number of high-profile Sega games, most notably his personal R360, and Jackson would frequently spend many hours playing with friends or by himself. Having developed a fascination with the emerging gaming industry, Jackson was keen to discover the latest technology when visiting Japan while touring. His celebrity allowed him to access his corporate idols, and Jackson made many trips to Sega's headquarters. Here, he developed a close relationship with executive Hisashi Suzuki. Looking to challenge their competitor Nintendo in the US and European markets, who could be better to help than the mega famous pop superstar whose endorsement got Pepsi rivaling Coca-Cola in soft drink sales? Sega therefore started discussing with Jackson the possibility of developing his 1988 musical film Moonwalker into a full-blown video game experience. After the programmers put together the game specs and showed Michael what the characters looked like, he would suggest refinements based on things he liked from playing games for so long. Not satisfied with merely licensing his image, Michael got just as involved in the game's development as he did the music film it was based off of. This meant that Michael Jackson ended up working with Sega's programming team, tweaking the visuals and personally designing some of the game's mechanics and ideas. Sega's marketing director, Al Nilsson, telling press outlets that Jackson was involved in Moonwalker from start to finish, quote, "Michael's a big video game player. The whole game is based on his ideas." Unlike with his Pepsi endorsement, which his dislike for the product meant that Jackson specified he wouldn't be holding or drinking the product in any commercial, or LA Gear sneakers, another product that the superstar didn't care much for, Michael loved Sega and the product being developed. Therefore, the whole process was a video games buff's dream, to have a game personally designed to your specifications, in which you are the protagonist of. Because of this, the pop superstar's payout from the Japanese tech company was likely nothing as headline-grabbing as the millions he received from previous endorsement deals. A favorable royalty fee, possibly, but the venture was likely a passion project that acted as a savvy, multi-level way to promote his direct-to-video music film and its associated music. Also, Michael Jackson was interested in expanding his influence outside of music and into new territories like movies, television, and video gaming, as demonstrated in the 360 deal he signed with Sony Music a year later, and undoubtedly felt having connections with Sega would only help his pursuit of this. A prototype of the full gameplay was first demonstrated at Mexico's American Amusement Machine Association exhibition in early July 1990. Soon after, Moonwalker was released internationally, with heavy marketing not only to promote the game, but the Sega Genesis console itself.
Michael Jackson's Moonwalker.
Sega! In the game, there's a very sinister backstory, as Mr. Big, the devious mastermind of all organized crime, has plotted to kidnap all the little girls of the world and brainwash them into becoming his slaves. If the great gloved one doesn't do something, soon the power of love will be snuffed out completely. MJ therefore begins a six-round brawl in Club 30, the seediest night spot in town. In each stage, three per round, the object is to locate and rescue a number of captive children while dispatching the goons. Bubbles the chimpanzee, Michael's real-life pet, arrives in each level. Once collected or rescued, the chimp transforms Michael into a robotic version of the pop singer that has the ability to absorb significantly more damage and shoot laser bursts. Not representing the average player's idea of an action game hero, Moonwalker's programmers included many of Jackson's well-known dance moves into the on-screen character's attack repertoire. The power of these attacks are dependent on how much styled magic, life, he has left. Or he can use the more devastating hat attack or dance attack, which costs him a significant proportion of his magic meter. The music and sound effects only add to the whole gaming experience, and gives it a distinctive Jackson edge. Some of the superstar's greatest hits are featured whether visually on screen or as background music, including Bad, Billie Jean, Beat It, or Thriller, with a whole zombie-inspired level included in the game console version. As Michael's music plays in the background, the gloved character screams and shrieks with every move in a realistic high-pitched voice. Launching in North America in July 1990, by the September it was the top-grossing new video game on the Replay arcade charts and received generally positive reviews. However, many commented that the gameplay itself, although it was an interesting concept, wasn't groundbreaking when compared to what was already available on the market. Others compared it to similar games, with one reviewer saying, quote, "It's basically a kicking and punching game a la Double Dragon and dozens of other Nintendo games." Megatech said that the console version was an addictive platform game that had excellent graphics. Mega Magazine placed the game at number 91 in their list of the best Sega games of all time, saying it was average. And in 2004, the Genesis version of Moonwalker was inducted into GameSpot's list of the greatest games of all time. Although a success, it was noted that Michael Jackson may have not made as much of a mark on the gaming industry because the film and music the game was based on was released some 2 or 3 years before, and its timing meant that Sega had already missed out on the second wave of Michael Mania that was brought on by the release of Bad in 1987. By 1990, the Gloved One was back in his self-imposed isolation, and the following year would release a whole new era of music and visuals that would make the video game Moonwalker look completely out of date. Failing to make a significant dent on Nintendo's dominance, Sega hired Tom Kalinske as president of Sega of America to run their new campaign. Among Kalinske's changes was a significant price reduction in the console, and instead of bundling the console purchases with Moonwalker, they replaced it with Sega's new game, Sonic the Hedgehog, featuring Sega's newest mascot of the same name. Kalinske's changes gave Genesis the edge over the NES by 1991, and led off the start of the console war between Sega and Nintendo. This console war between Sega and Nintendo lasted until 1994, when Sony Computer Entertainment disrupted both companies with the release of the PlayStation.